Now that we're familiar with the SCIR model, we can easily modify it to fit the current situation for the coronavirus. The death rate is estimated to be at about 3.4% as of March 2020, so we'll add that to the model as the death rate. We'll let it flow from the infectious population to the D group, which represents everyone who suffered the disease-related death. The rest of the equations are the same as before. I've chosen Russia as the country to model. Currently, there are 28 total cases, 3 total recovered, 25 active cases, and no deaths. Though these 25 cases are likely to be quarantined or in the hospital, we will use these numbers as our initial values. This is what we get when we run our code. I may upload a video in the future discussing the code. As you can see, the disease outbreak starts to get noticeable after around 100 days from March 12th. Because this is a deterministic model, the number of infectious people will eventually be zero, and the people will either have died or recovered or will have remained unaffected by the outbreak. But we can make some modifications in our model. For example, after everyone starts getting more cautious or if the government subsidizes hand sanitizer, we can expect the effective contact rate to decrease. What will happen to the graph when we take this into account? In this example, I will show what the effects of reducing the effective contact rate will have on the simulation. I've written down the number of deaths and the maximum infectious cases, where the peak of the yellow line on the right side, so that we can compare different scenarios. As you can see in this comic, if we flatten our yellow infectious curve, then this can be beneficial for hospitals, as they are less likely to be overcrowded when the outbreak peaks. We will try and create this effect in our simulations. This is what happens when the contact rate, for whatever reason, decreases after 150 days. From now on, I will call this the policy effect for simplicity. We can see that the graph's shape changes after the 150th day mark. Note that the total deaths have decreased, but the maximum infectious cases have stayed the same, because the policy took effect after the peak. The effects are even more pronounced if the policy takes effect 1 month earlier at the 120th day mark. If the policy effect takes place 20 days after the outbreak, then the effects were so great that I had to look at a span of 2 years instead of one. The slowed effects of the outbreak would be great for any country as there is more time to develop a vaccine. Furthermore, by comparing the number of total deaths, we see that the early policy effect had saved more than 10 million lives in this simulation.